Want to download and play Minecraft modpacks? Well, that's what I'll show you in today's video. This video will show you how to download modpacks using a mod launcher. Chapters are provided in the video for you to navigate to the section you want. To install modpacks quickly and seamlessly, we want to download a mod launcher. Installing a modpack on the Minecraft launcher could get messy and annoying to work with. Plus, with a mod launcher, we could separate our modded instances from our vanilla ones. There's lots of choices to choose from, but for the purpose of this video, I will use the Prism launcher, though feel free to use whichever mod launcher you want. Links to download other mod launchers will be in the description. If you've already installed your mod launcher, skip to this segment of the video, as the first two steps are not required. If you want to download Prism, here's how to do so. Go into your web browser and search Minecraft Prism, and click on the link that takes you to prismlauncher.org. Press download. There's download options for Windows, macOS, Linux, or Steam Deck. For me, I'm going to select Windows and download the installer file. If you're on a Windows operating system, Microsoft Visual C++ is required for the mod launcher to run properly. If you don't have that on your system, download and install that first, before proceeding further. To those who aren't downloading Prism, search for your mod launcher in your web browser and follow the download steps your respective mod launcher requires. To install your mod launcher, go to the location you downloaded it and run it. For users who are using a different mod launcher, follow the steps your installer provides. For those using Prism, proceed further. Installing the following options here are entirely optional. Check any or all components if you want to install them. Continue on. Choose where you want to install the mod launcher. Once a directory is selected, press install. Check this box if you want Prism to run after the setup is completed. Press finish. After following the installation steps for your mod launcher, you are now ready to install a modpack. Now we'll want to decide on a modpack to download. If you're not sure what modpack to install, CurseForge and Modrinth offer a wide assortment of modpacks to choose from. Mod launchers like the AT Launcher, Feed the Beast, and Technic feature their own assortment of modpacks to choose from as well. Mod launchers allow you to install modpacks automatically without much trouble. Here's how to do so. For this example, I'm using the Prism Launcher, but use whichever mod launcher you want. To install a modpack, create a new instance. On the left-hand side, there are a few third-party sites to install modpacks. For an automatic installation, select the site you want to use to install your modpack. For me, I'll select CurseForge. One thing to note about CurseForge is that mods can be denied access by a mod launcher, like Prism or MultiMC. Should you install a CurseForge modpack, you may need to manually install any mods that the modpack requires. I'm going to refine my search by searching for all the mods. All the mod 6 will be the mod pack I'm going to download, so I'll select that. Make sure to read through the mod pack description to see if there's any requirements or notes about installing the mod pack. For the case of all the mod 6, there is none, so we can install the mod pack. For you, select the mod pack you want to install, select the mod pack version on the right, and press OK to begin the installation. Depending on how large your selected modpack is, the time to install it may differ. If a mod is blocked access, you'll get a prompt like such. For the case of the pack I'm downloading, SpawnerFix is unable to install it through Prism, so I'll have to manually install it. Make sure to note any blocked mods if this happens to you, and install them manually after the pack is installed. After your modpack is installed and you've added any blocked mods, check your Java version to make sure it is good to go. To do this, select your modpack instance and press Edit. Navigate to the settings. Check the Java installation button. The following Minecraft versions require these versions of Java to run properly. AllTheMod 6 was made for 1.16.5, meaning it needs Java 8 to run. If you need to change it, select the Auto Detect button. If your Java versions are in the same directory, your mod launcher should register all your versions of Java. Java 8 is denoted by 1.8, so that's what I'll select. Press OK and run your modpack. And there we go, our modpack has been installed. Some larger modpacks may be more taxing to run than others, requiring additional memory to run. Fortunately, if you use a mod launcher, increasing your memory usage is a simple process. GregTech New Horizons, for example, requires a minimum of 3GB to run, with a preferred option of 4GB. I want to increase my memory allocation to match the recommended settings GregTech New Horizons suggests. So how will I go about doing that? With our case for Prism, or your mod launcher of choice, head back into your chosen instance and press Edit. Navigate to the settings, and check the memory button on. Now you can adjust the minimum and maximum memory value your computer will allocate to this instance. 1GB equates to 1024 MB of RAM. Therefore, 3 times 1024 equals 3072 MB, or 3GB. So I'll add that into my minimum memory slot. 1024 times by 4 equals 4096 MB. Which is what I'll add for the maximum memory allocation. Make sure to not allocate too much memory, otherwise your game could perform worse than before. Now that's done, press launch, and our modpack should load properly. That's how to download and play Minecraft modpacks, and hopefully you found this video helpful.